Hi friends, we are today going to show what are the purchase order types, and one of my colleagues will discuss you what are the purchase order types in Dynamics AX. So please proceed.
Hi everybody, now I am going to explain about the purchase order of different types. Normally in business which is having trading, manufacturing, every business will have stocked item. The key business item which they are purchasing and selling, for those items they will be preparing purchase order separately. In those purchase order, the landing cost will be posted on to item cost. Along with the purchase item value, the landing cost of transportation and other charges will be loaded, so that the cost of goods will come with the cost of purchase. The next type is service item. Company also purchase service for maintenance, repair, and auditor, and different type of technical consultancy. Those service also can be created using item which is having service type item. For that also we can prepare a purchase order. This item, service item purchase order, is non-stock type. That means these purchase order, when you are posting, closing stock will not be there, inventory will not be updated, but the transaction will be captured and financial posting will be posted. The third type is purchase order for category. Many purchases, you cannot exactly specify what you need. You will need some office cleaning material. Cleaning material you will write. Whatever available, they will supply. So those time, you can define it as a category. You need not define an exact item. You can say generally cleaning material. Okay. For that, you can use purchase order category type. This is also a service item.
Is there any impact on hand?
This will not have inventory. This is non-stock purchase. Okay. And during service purchase order and non-stock category purchase order, user can manually select the ledger account to which they want to post it.
This entry is made in purchase order or purchase order journal?
Purchase order.
Okay.
In purchase order line, you can select the ledger account. During our next demo, we will explain how to create it. The fourth type is purchase order for non-stock item. For example, stationery. Whatever item you are purchasing for your business or operation purpose, not for purchasing and selling, those items are called non-stock item, for which you will not maintain the closing stock and inventory. You may track the quantity, but you will not take as a closing stock. All the purchases will be expensed out. You will treat it as a expenses. Okay. Another important type is AX has the facility to create fixed asset purchase order. You can purchase fixed assets using purchase order. There are 2-3 more types are there. Those type we will explain when we are releasing video related to fixed asset. Here we will I want to explain you the purchase order for fixed asset. You create normal purchase order, normal item, inventory item, select those item. There is a tab available in detail with fixed asset. You select there the required option. System will allow you to purchase fixed asset. When you are posting GRN, goods received will be posted as a inventory. Once you are posting invoice, the invoice will be transferred along with the inventory as a fixed asset. This facility is available in AX. And very important thing is import purchase order. Import purchase order you can create for stocked item, non-stock item. And import purchase order really mostly will be in foreign currency. System has the facility to track those import purchase order. import purchase order has few restriction. We will look into those during our next session. Okay. Now I will explain you how to create purchase order. Create a purchase order. You go to account payable, comment, all purchase order. Click on purchase order. Then select the appropriate supplier. After selecting the purchase supplier, the supplier may have multiple location. If you want to change supplier location, you can change by selecting from here. If you have multiple address, you can select the appropriate address from where you are going to purchase it. In general, FASTag, there is one number showing 4 times 0 38. This is your purchase order number. When you are expanding purchase order, you have to always select a site and warehouse in which you are going to receive the stock. Okay, after that, all other details are not mandatory. You can select it wherever required. Purchase pool and many other facilities are available. Okay, click OK. Now system will insert a new purchase order. This purchase order screen has two part in action plan. One is header view, another is line. It is a good practice to go to header always and select the appropriate site and warehouse and the payment terms and other information related to the transaction. Then you select the appropriate address. Very important is the dimension whatever required. You select the appropriate dimension. Here, what is the advantage? Once you select dimension here and save the screen, it will update for all the line. When you are creating multiple line, all the line will be automatically updated with the
financial
dimension. Now come to line. Purchase order line, then select the item which you want to buy. For every item, very important thing is you should enter the quantity and value. You have to put the quantity you want to buy, 10, the price per item, enter it. After this, system will show you the total line amount. This purchase order value is 340. If you have discount and tax and other thing, here in the action plan there is one total button available. You click on this. This will give you all the information of miscellaneous charges, tax, discount, everything. Okay. Now go to detail. Very important thing is purchase order detail has very detailed information. Very, very important is dimension. Since we entered in header, it will automatically come into line. Then come to setup. This is a place where you will be selecting the tax code if tax is applicable. If tax is not applicable, remove it. Then tax will not be calculated for the transaction. Anything related to dimension of the item, you have to enter here. If dimension is missed, then system will not allow you to confirm the purchase order. Okay. You can change the address here, and very important thing is in purchase order, any detailed information you want to enter, you can enter in this text bar. Okay, after this, these are the minimum information. Once you enter all the information, you can check what is your header detail here, the buyer information, the date of delivery, all those information is captured here. After this, you go to purchase and press confirmation. Once the purchase order is confirmed, now you will get your purchase order printout to which will be issued to